Well, supermarkets across the country could soon be subject to an inquiry into price gouging by the ACCC as Prime Minister Anthony Albanese takes aim at the rising cost of goods. Will it have any effect? To discuss, let's bring in Ritchie's IGA CEO, Fred Harrison from Mount Eliza in Victoria. Fred, good to see you. Have you had a shop shock lately? Because I think the whole of Australia has.
No question, Carl. I think supermarket bills have gone up significantly, particularly over the last 2 or 3 years. And of course, we've been comparing to very consistent pricing from about 2010 through to about 2020. So we are off a steady backdrop, but we have seen significant increases for sure in the last 2 or 3 years.
Fred, Coles and Woolies say not guilty, Your Honour. Do you believe otherwise?
No, look, I do believe the chains, Carl. I mean, I think we have a very robust and very competitive supermarket industry. And let me also add that there's been a lot of talk around produce pricing, around meat pricing. I mean, supermarkets are only a component of that market. For example, we know 50% of Australians shop in produce shops, 50% of Australians buy their meat from a butcher. Bakers, for example, I'm in Mount Eliza today. We have two supermarkets, Ritchie's and Woolworths. We've got three bakers. We have two magnificent produce shops and three excellent butchers. So there is an enormous choice and opportunity, and customers have the chance and the choice to check pricing, and they do ultimately vote with their feet.
Fred, there's an old saying in Australia that I love. It's not a rort unless you're in on it. I guess some people out there are going to say, well, hang on, Fred, IGA is in on it.
No, not at all. I mean, we've been working as a network now for the last three, four, 5 years to really improve our competitiveness in price. And we are getting more and more competitive each and every year. I mean, we do a lot of price matching. We have lockdown pricing. So we're very much about trying to provide the consumer with the best price possible. We must remember, like the consumer, we're all facing rising costs at the moment, whether that be electricity, whether it be your rent. So we're all in this together. I mean, I understand what the consumers are saying. It's a lot of pain at the moment. When you come into a supermarket and your bill might have come to $100 and it's now coming to $110 or $115, I get that people react. But can I just add, Carl, also, that if I take you back, say, 4 years ago, there was a bit of speculation around manufacturers having difficulty getting price increases through the industry. And that was a little bit the case, right, because they had to justify increases. So I think
what I'm seeing here, Fred, a mindset change in recent times. I understand. So what I'm seeing here and what I'm hearing here is that it doesn't really matter what the government does in terms of trying to address these prices, or if there's an inquiry by the ACCC, it won't have any real impact on the price of goods in a supermarket.
Oh, no, the government have a lot of power, Carl. They could make decisions and bring in rules that impact all of us. So I think until we know perhaps what the terms of reference are, and until we actually hear what the government end result is, I think it would be silly to think along those lines. I think they have a lot of power to bring in a lot of rules. So I think we very much await with a lot of interest as to where we do end up in the longer term. It will take a bit of time, naturally, but no one's taking this lightly. I think it's of major significance.
Alternatives are all good out there. Thank you so much for your time. Appreciate it, Sarah.
All right, well, the competition watchdog, the ACCC, has issued a stark warning to supermarket chains over discount claims as potential litigation looms. Peter, there's some concern the ACCC might not be able to do very much when it comes to price gouging, but is focusing on the was and now pricing system, could that be a start?
I think at the moment, the way things are going, the cost of living in this country is so out of control that Australians will go with anything that will actually bring into line grocery prices. I think the ACCC need to target, for example, Woolworths, who are in a world of pain at the moment over their stance on the Australia Day merchandising issue, and actually have a red hot go at bringing into line pricing. The ones I really feel sorry for are the farmers, who are absolutely being desecrated at the moment because of the way in which the big cartel-like supermarket chains, you know, extort them with prices. The other thing is here, this is a national scandal when you consider that Australian icon brands like Milo, Vegemite and Weet-Bix have all gone up about 27% pre-COVID. I mean, someone talk about un-Australian.
Yeah, someone needs to be held accountable, Michelle.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think the ACCC are dead right here. And the farmers are the ones who are really, really suffering. And we really need to do something to kind of get control of supermarkets. I mean, how many times do we have to go to the supermarket and scan our own stuff? And, you know, I feel like I'm doing the job for them and I'm not getting anything in return. Yeah. So I think the supermarkets 100% need to be looked under a microscope.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, under mounting pressure to ease the cost of living, Prime Minister Anthony Albanese is trying to fast-track relief before the May federal budget.
For more, let's bring in the Motley Fool's Scott Phillips. Scott, good morning.
Scotty.
Good to see you today. Now, cash handouts are out. So what measures is the government considering?
Good morning, Carl. Sarah, welcome back to the air, by the way. Great to have you back. The federal government is apparently considering, we know this almost as selective leaks to our national newspapers and, of course, to the media in general. They are considering things like energy bill relief, more subsidies for electricity and gas in particular. They have apparently ruled out cash handouts, fearful of the impact that might have on inflation, but very keen to address the cost of living from, I dare say, both economic and political grounds.
I feel like the Australian public... It's all white noise coming from the government right now because they're just not seeing anything that helps them pay the bills.
And, mate, that's about right, because there has been nothing. For all of the talk from the Prime Minister and Treasurer about the fact that cost of living is their number one focus, they've done everything they can to help with the cost of living, I think almost everyone's looking around saying, well, just exactly what have you done? Yeah. You know, what have the Romans ever done for us, as they say? there is nothing to show for it. A little bit of rent relief a while ago, an increase in pensions and other welfare payments in line with inflation, which is largely an automatic process anyway. But in terms of specific actions taken by the government to do something about it, there has been nothing. Now, the flip side, of course, is if cost of living relief is effectively more stimulus for the economy, at the same time the RBA is trying to cool things down. Mm. So it is a very difficult thing for them to do. But thus far, for all the talk, there's nothing to show for it.
No, absolutely. And we know that households across the country are all doing what they can to try and cut the costs of living. I mean, we know that the Queensland Premier, for example, will grill the executives of some of those leading supermarkets about cutting those costs and why it does cost so much. What's going to happen there?
It's a good question because Stephen Miles really doesn't have much in the way of regulatory power. I mean, they could try and implement some new state laws or something else, but realistically, this is the old... Glenn Stevens used to talk about jawboning the economy. This is Stephen Miles trying to jawbone the big supermarkets, basically trying to convince them that, hey, if I shine enough light on you guys, you'll do something about it. Now, it's fair to say that has worked to some degree. Both the state and federal pressure has seen some supermarkets, or Coles in particular, cut some of their meat prices by up to 20%. Mm. So we shouldn't say it's not going to do anything at all, but there's nothing specific and direct he can do. He's got to hope that shining that light will make a difference. Okay.